It's time for round two of How Long Can You Survive? Where in the universe could you simultaneously die and live forever? How long would you last if infected with one of the most deadly diseases in the world? What would it be like surviving inside the stomach of a T-Rex? Let's find out. We're going to start by flying high. If you jumped out of an airplane without a parachute, how long would you survive? Most skydivers start to jump around 10,000 feet. That means if you free fell all the way to the ground, you'd last around 37 seconds before impact. At least for about 30 seconds, you would have a beautiful view. There are some skydivers who jump from higher altitudes. In those extreme circumstances, you'd survive slightly longer. If you jump from a plane at 14,000 feet, you would survive about 50 seconds of free-falling before hitting the ground. And from 18,000 feet, you'd last 61 seconds. Depending on what altitude you left the plane at, you could calculate just how long you had before the Earth welcomed you back home. In the last video, we talked about how long you could last on the Sun, Mercury, and in the vastness of space. But what about the other planets? You may be surprised that there are places in the solar system that are even more hostile than the closest planet to the Sun. Let's start with the next planet, Venus. This world might have been Earth's twin a long, long time ago. If this were still the case, you could survive to the average old age of humans, which is around 70.6 years for men and 75 years for women. Unfortunately, Venus has a runaway greenhouse effect that literally makes it more hell-like than Earth. Venus is about the same size as our planet, so the gravity is pretty similar. However, its atmospheric pressure and temperature are vastly different. The second planet from the Sun has an average temperature of around 9,000 degrees Fahrenheit. In less than 1 second, you would be vaporized by those hostile conditions. Unlike Venus and Earth, Mars is cold and has a very thin atmosphere. On the red planet, you'd be able to survive a bit longer. In fact, if you had some extremely warm clothing or a spacesuit, you could survive on Mars indefinitely. That is, if you had enough food, water, and air to breathe. Although these seem like big obstacles to overcome, it's definitely better than being incinerated on Venus. If you're bundled up, you could survive around 2 minutes on Mars before you died from the lack of oxygen. Now things are going to get a little more intense, because the next planet is the largest in the solar system. Jupiter has a lot of mass, and anything that has large amounts of mass has large amounts of gravity. There are a couple of problems with trying to survive on Jupiter, and any of the gas giants in our solar system for that matter, since they're made almost entirely of gas. If you try stepping on one of the planets, you'll fall right through toward its center. At some point you would hit solid ground, but you'd be dead long before that happened. You wouldn't descend very far before the pressure from all the gas around you would crush your body. On Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, you would survive less than a second of falling through their gases before you were compressed into a marble-sized version of yourself. Technically, Pluto is not a planet, but it's still worth mentioning what would happen to you on this faraway hunk of space rock. The problem with a human surviving on Pluto is the lack of heat. The gravity on Pluto is around 1/5 that of Earth, so you'd most definitely not be crushed to death. If you could get a pickup game of basketball going, you'd be really good, since you'd be able to jump about 25 feet off the ground. The problem with Pluto is that there is no air and no heat. The dwarf planet is so far away from the Sun that the average temperature is around negative 375 degrees Fahrenheit, so within seconds it would freeze you to death. If you were really resilient, you could probably last around 10 seconds, but it would be an unpleasant experience. This brings us to the most terrifying monster in the universe, black holes. How long would you last if you were to be sucked into a black hole? Since these mysterious objects seem to bend the laws of physics to their will, the answer to this question is quite surprising. If you were to fall into a black hole, you could be both pulled apart by gravity and frozen in time. How is this possible? I'm glad you asked. Let's imagine you were floating toward a black hole. Everything would be fine until you started closing in on the event horizon. This is where gravity is so intense that nothing, not even light, can escape. As you get closer to the singularity at the center of a black hole, the gravity becomes more and more intense. The problem is that this happens extremely quickly. There are massive changes in gravity every centimeter. For a few seconds, your feet are being pulled toward the center of the black hole quicker than the top of your body. Your body would begin to stretch. This might feel good for a split second. It would straighten your spine and stretch your muscles. However, as you approach the event horizon, the gravity is so intense it would literally stretch your body out into a thin noodle shape. This is aptly named spaghettification. So, from your perspective, you would survive until part of your body approached the event horizon of the black hole, and a few seconds later you would be dead as your body stretched into spaghetti. However, this is where things get really strange. As you approach the event horizon and gravity increases, time seems to slow down for someone who is observing you from outside the black hole. To that person, you would seem to be moving so slowly that it'd be hard for them to tell if you were moving at all. This all has to do with perspective, and what one really smart man named Albert Einstein called relativity. Basically, the more gravity or faster you're moving, the slower time moves for you than someone who is observing you. Therefore, as you approach the intense gravity of the event horizon, you would seem to slow down, and once you hit the event horizon, you would seem to freeze completely. This means, to an outside observer, you would be alive just before the event horizon practically forever, because it would take many of their lifetimes before your body would pass beyond that point and disappear into the singularity of the black hole. Eventually, you would just disappear from the observer's perspective, but it'd take a very, very long time. Let's head a little closer to home and see how you'd last in a shark attack. If we start with the best case scenario, you could survive for a while. A single shark could take quite a while to kill you, even if it was a great white. Shark experts recommend some key responses to help you survive the shark attack. Most are easier said than done, like don't panic and don't lose sight of the shark, and try to slowly back away. Sharks don't really enjoy the taste of humans, so if the shark lets go, you have a good chance of surviving. That being said, a shark bite can take a chunk of skin and muscle with it. The biggest threat after a shark attack is bleeding out. The good news is, you'll have several minutes to seek help. However, if attacked by a large shark that takes a big bite, you have about 5 minutes until you bleed to death. This will vary based on the hole the shark created in your body, but you will have at least a few minutes to seek help. The worst case scenario is when there are multiple sharks and a feeding frenzy starts. In this scenario, hundreds of sharks could be biting you all at the same time, ripping your body apart. How long would you survive a shark feeding frenzy, you might ask? Your body would be torn apart in a matter of seconds, so you would barely have time to process what was happening before your vital organs were ripped from your body and swallowed by the sharks. Most of us never have to worry about one of the most deadly diseases in the world. However, this is not true for everyone. How long would you survive if infected by rabies? Keep in mind that this disease has a mortality rate of 99.9% in humans. First, let's put your mind at ease. Rabies is preventable if you are vaccinated against the virus. Even if you haven't been vaccinated, if you're attacked by an animal with rabies, you can get a shot, which will allow your body to fight off the virus before it kills you. The problem is, if you don't get treated in time, you will die. The scariest thing about rabies is that once symptoms start to show, it's almost certainly fatal. The incubation period for the virus is between 2 to 3 months, so if you're infected with rabies, you will survive at least that long. However, once you start showing symptoms such as hyperactivity, cardiovascular complications, the development of phobias or paralysis, you have between 2 and 10 days before the disease kills you. After learning about how long you'd survive in all these situations, you might have decided it's a scary world out there. Perhaps you'd survive longer if you just stayed in bed. But you'd be surprised how not moving at all can take a significant toll on your body. How long could you survive if you never moved? Well, it'd be longer than if you were on another planet, or went skydiving without a parachute. But not moving at all would eventually kill you. Let's imagine you have all the food, water, and other necessities you need to survive, but just never got out of bed. Eventually, you run into complications. After a couple weeks, your body would begin to become weaker due to lack of muscle and bone use. Within 6 months to a year, depending on the person, your body would begin to develop ulcers and bed sores. These would not kill you, but you'd be extremely uncomfortable. At this point, your mental health would begin to deteriorate as well, because we evolved to be nomadic, and laying in one place without moving is not what your body was designed to do. Even with all the vitamins and nutrients you needed to survive, your muscles would become so weak that circulating your blood would eventually become too much and your heart would fail. So, if you never moved, you could survive for about 2 years before your body gave up. What about if you were trapped in a car, underwater? Not only is this a real fear, but unlike being sucked into a black hole, this could happen to you. If you careened off the road and ended up submerged underwater in your car, you could actually survive for a decent amount of time. Supposing that there was no damage to the windows or doors, the car would keep out most of the water. It may slowly begin to fill up, but something else would kill you long before the water did. Since you would be contained in your own little underwater world, you would have the oxygen that was currently in the car to breathe. However, with each breath, you would be poisoning your own air. You'd be taking in the oxygen and replacing it with carbon dioxide. When the air in the car reaches about 15% carbon dioxide, you would die. So, how long would this take? If you could remain calm, which given the circumstances would be extremely difficult, you could last around 15 hours in a submerged car. However, you would probably start to feel fatigued and ill before that due to the high amounts of carbon dioxide that is poisoning your body. A more realistic number for length of survival in a completely submerged car with no leaks would be about 5 hours. The last survival scenario is something straight out of the Cretaceous. How long would you survive if you were swallowed whole by a T-Rex? Obviously, this could never happen, because T-Rexes are extinct, unless some mad scientist decided to make Jurassic Park a real thing. Also, this would never happen because the T-Rex would tear you apart and eat you piece by piece rather than swallowing you whole. But just for fun, Let's imagine you found yourself inside the pit of a T-Rex stomach. How long would you survive? We don't know exactly what the digestive system of a T-Rex was like, but we can make educated guesses based on animals alive today that share DNA with the king of the dinosaurs. Surprisingly, one such animal is the chicken. If you were swallowed whole by a T-Rex, you would have to avoid acid burns within their stomach. This might be done by pushing against the mucus-covered walls of the dino's stomach lining, but eventually you would get tired and end up in the dinosaur's digestive acid. It's likely your body would be digested and then pooped out a day or two later. So if swallowed whole by a T-Rex, you'd probably survive a few minutes before being digested alive by stomach acid. If you could make it all the way through the digestive tract in one piece, you'd come out the other end a couple of days after being swallowed. Now watch How Long Can You Survive? Or check out Could You Survive Living Underground Forever?